Hi, I'm Bill Campbell from the International Practical Shooting Confederation, and my club is called the Practical Pistol League of Australia. IPSC is a very dynamic sport. It's an exciting sport. It's an action pistol sport. It's a sport where the competitor is challenged both mentally and physically by being given a problem to sort out for himself in a manner that where he can shoot the course of fire as quickly and as accurately as possible. Within IPSC, there are 85 different countries around the world shooting this sport, which gives us a total of about 25,000 members worldwide. Australian competitors compete in their own country at a national level, a state level, and a local club level. So there are many, many competitions available to all members of IPSC. We use different firearms. We're restricted by government law to 38 and 9 mil, but within the sport of IPSC, there are many different firearms used. The PPLA is Australia's and Victoria's biggest IPSC dedicated club. At this facility, we have 22 pistol ranges that we can utilise for handgun competitions. We can run national championships and state level competitions. Our average attendance on club competition days is about 75 to 80 competitors, at a state level competition in excess of 200, and in a national competition in excess of 300 competitors. The national competitors come from every state in Australia, with many, many shooters coming from as far as Perth and Darwin when we hold the national championships. We also gain international competitors. Australians compete at a very high level in international competition. The PPLA was formed in the late 70s and was the first IPSC club in Victoria and the second IPSC club in Australia. We have a very, very large membership base, and some of our competitors and members are extremely well known within the IPSC world, both in Australia, Victoria, and around the international scene as well. Here at the PPLA, our biggest emphasis is on safety. Safety is absolutely paramount. In fact, the first three rules of the club, safety, safety, safety. You must be aware that firing real bullets, therefore safety is absolutely the first thing we instruct all new members in. We spend quite a considerable time with them before we even let them have a firearm. They are lectured, description of the firearm is given to them, how to use the firearm is given to them, just to make sure that everyone is safe at all times. IPSC shooting is such a dynamic sport. We are running, we are opening doors, we're shooting through ports in walls, we're shooting around corners, we're shooting one-handed. So therefore, safety is of extreme importance. You will be disqualified from the competition if you breach any safety rule. It's very important. It's the same no matter where you go in the world to shoot IPSC, the rules are the same. We have an international rule book and everybody plays by the same rules. If you break the rules, you are disqualified from the competition immediately. Membership of PPLA is open to any person from 12 years of age upwards can apply to join the club. The training that we give our members is quite extensive, and a number of our own members are licensed government testers, licensed by the Victoria Police to actually carry out all the training and the testing of our members. Junior members under the age of 18, between the ages of 12 and 18, cannot own a firearm, obviously, but they are allowed to compete and they are allowed to gain a junior license. And again, the training for that is quite extensive. To gain a handgun license in Victoria is quite an involved process. You must join an approved pistol club. You must pass a police check after your application to join the club. You are then issued with a 6-month minimum provisional license, during which time the club will train you in all aspects of safe gun handling and gun ownership requirements. That is held for a minimum of 6 months. Once you have gained that and you have a minimum quantity of competitions under your belt, you can then apply for a full general category handgun license. Then After holding that for a period of time, you can actually apply to buy your own firearm. So minimally, we're looking at 9-12 months prior to you being able to purchase your own firearm from the day you join. It is quite involved, there are quite a lot of restrictions and testing from the new member, and provided you pass the clearance of the police, then you can continue to maintain your membership of an approved handgun club. During your initial 6 months of membership of the club has its own club firearms, which all new members will be instructed in the use of, and will have access to those firearms for training. It's a one-on-one training situation, and you're held responsible for the way you use the firearm under the control of the range official who is actually looking after you. The targets we use in IPSC are paper targets or metallic reactive targets. In other words, the metallic target will fall over when activated or shot at. We also have swinging targets and we also have partial targets. The scoring on the targets is dictated by the firearm that you use. There are two levels of firearm within IPSC, major and minor power factors. The major factor is the 38 Super or Open Division gun. Major factor can also be scored in standard division, and production is actually minor power factor. The scoring values for the hits on the targets for major factor are 5 points for the A zone, 4 points for the C zone, and 2 points for the D zone. In minor power factor, we get 5 points for the A zone, 3 points for the C zone, and 1 point for the D zone. With a metallic target, all targets are scored as 5 points and they must either fall over or be activated to actually get the score. If you miss the target, then you obviously get no score. We also have penalty targets. The penalty targets are the clear white ones. A shot on a penalty target will incur a 10-point penalty per shot up to a maximum of 2 shots. The partial targets are dictated by the match designer's imagination. However, a fair portion of the higher scoring zone must always also be visible. The targets can be across this way, be across this way, it can be marked down, can be any design he chooses, as long as the section of the A zone showing. A hit on here incurs a miss penalty or a 0 score, unless the competitor backs up the shot. So all paper targets must have 2 scoring hits on them. One shot on here results in a penalty of 1 miss and only the score for the buff coloured target. Okay, this is what's known as a paper popper, and it is a metallic reactive target. A hit on this will cause the target to fall forward as such. This gets you a 5-point score. A miss on this target will obviously be a 10-point penalty for the miss. This is a metallic reactive target called a pepper popper. These fall forward when they're hit and they're used on their own or to activate a moving target, as you will see demonstrated here. So the shooter will come into whatever position he's deciding to shoot it from, fire a shot, shot is hit, activates the swinging target, which the shooter then has to engage whilst the target is obviously moving. Very difficult shot. Other metal reactive targets that we use are steel plates. These plates are 6 inches or 150 millimeters square, and when hit, they just fall over. These all metal targets have to be no closer than 7 meters to the shooter for safety's sake. Within IPSC, as we've stated before, safety is absolutely paramount. When a competitor puts his firearm on, he cannot take it out unless he is under the direct control of a range officer on the range when he's just about to shoot. Other than that, we have the safety areas. Competitors are allowed to go into a safety area. Once they're inside this enclosed area, it is a non-point where competitors can remove the firearm to carry out any checks, replacing the batteries in the electronic sights on the open guns, or carrying out any other component changes or modifications that they need to do to the firearm to make sure that it's safe and working efficiently. Whilst in a safety area, the competitor cannot handle any ammunition. If a competitor handles the ammunition, he may be disqualified from the competition. Some clubs actually stop you from taking ammunition into the safety zone, but as long as you do not handle it, you're safe. when a competitor actually comes up onto the range to actually start shooting, there are a couple of mandatory items that a competitor must be wearing. Fully enclosed footwear, earmuffs, and safety glasses. So prior to shooting, safety glasses on, earmuffs on, and then we're ready for the range official to take over and take control of you prior to you shooting. Load and make ready. Are you ready? Stand by. If you have finished, unload and show clear. If clear, hammer down and holster. Range is clear. Time, 2.77 seconds.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, within IPSC, there are four major divisions. The divisions that we use are built into the category of the firearm. This is an open gun with the open configuration. There's also standard division, production division, and a revolver division. There is another division known as modified, but very few people shoot that division. The allowances for open division are such that I can change the firearm and custom build the firearm with as many modifications as I choose to make. The open division firearm is completely different to most firearms in as much that it has a muzzle brake or compensator. The slide can be lightened to allow for a little bit more speed. We have electronic sights on the firearm, which are a red dot that you see within the sight itself. It doesn't project anywhere. It just sits on the sight lens in the front. We have a racking lever here to make it easier to open and close the firearm during reloading and clearing. And there's a thumb rest. Also, there's a very large magazine well to allow for easier insertion and faster insertion of the magazine. The trigger can be lightened right down, so it's quite light. 1.5 pounds is quite normal. And these firearms are in open division. The other divisions that we have in the sport are standard division. And my friend here, John, is set up for standard division. As you can see, there is no equipment on the front of his body. All the equipment is behind the hip line. We're allowed to carry as many magazines as we choose, but we must use the equipment from the belt. Okay, the firearm is a standard division firearm, and John will explain the situation with that.
This is pretty much like the open, except that there are no optics on the top, but you do have a jet funnel mag base. You can make certain modifications like a fiber optic sight and some modifications on the internal workings of the handgun. And the other item about this particular handgun is that it must fit in the box that's designated for standard division. The production gun is the same as the standard gun, except that it's straight out of the box, no modifications whatsoever. And there's a certain list of production guns that can only be used. So there are some guns that are restricted